It's still Thursday. Happy Thursday. I am going to go out to the garage / man cave. I'm going to drag you with me because I am going out to get a well-deserved brewski. I need one after the abuse I dealt with today at the cubicle farm. Yes, just excuse the sun for a minute there. Oh, thank God for shade. And, I almost had a mini kid. Oh my. Hold on, I gotta put you down. Oh my God. Ay. Note to self. Don't walk barefoot on tarmac in the summer when you have to stop. So I had a rough day at the cubicle farm today, and want to help me pick a brew. I want something. Yes. De-freaking-lish. I'm not sure I can slam a beer right now. Actually, I could. That's a lie. But something juicy feels good right now. I want to know. Put you there so I can talk and drink and open my beer at the same time. Yes. I multitask well. Sometimes. What do you do when your bosses are all bitches? In the sense that, well, not bitches like bitch face, because that's just one kind of bitch, but bitches in the sense that they're all a bunch of pussies, you know? I think I should just sit down. Let's just sit down right here and have a drink al fresco. So what's the use in having a boss or a manager that doesn't manage, you know? I've got plenty of people to complain to. 5, in fact. Actually, no, 4. I got 4 bosses to complain to. But the trouble is, they all agree that the problem people are problems. They all agree wholeheartedly, and they all talk about it amongst themselves and amongst ourselves. We heavily state what the problems are at the cubicle with certain people, certain farm animals. But the trouble is, although we all agree on these problems, nothing is said to those people because they're afraid that those people will leave. I say, fuck 'em. They do nothing but make everybody miserable anyway, you know? For example, today, one of the agents, problem agents, was really nasty with me on the phone because she had 2 clients walk into the office and she told them both to come in, that somebody would there be. I'm quite frazzled. She said that somebody would be at the office to help them, but she didn't bother to call the office and give anybody a heads up that they were coming, nor did she bother to call anybody and ask them if they would mind taking care of these 2 clients for her. What she'd done was, she'd pissed off to Pennsylvania in the middle of the work week and decided that she needed to get away, so she pissed off to Pennsylvania and figured it was okay, as usual, to just dump her work on the other people in the office because she knows she can't. She knows that people won't tell her to because, you know, she just knows how it rolls in there and she knows she can get away with it, and it's really getting on my nerves. So what do you do when, you know, when you have bosses that agree with you yet do nothing to solve the problem? Unfortunately, this Clarichek has to grin and bear it. But fortunately, I have a nice garden and cold brewskis to come home to and help me chill. And now that I think about it, I think I need to start procrastinating. Yeah. Oh no! I think I've killed him. Oh, not cool. Oh. That is... Oh, that one's alright. That is so not cool, and that is so... all my fault. On a happy note... on a happy note about the dead trees... a friend slash client came over yesterday and brought us 3 new red maple saplings, and they were beautiful. They were beautiful yesterday when she brought them over, and you know, when I put them in the yard. But unfortunately, today they were sitting out in the sun all day with the roots exposed in plastic bags with a little bit of dirt. And hopefully I can save them. I have to go rustle around now and try and find some pots to bury those roots in and see if I can get my black thumb a little bit greener. Alright, thanks for listening to me, bitch guys. I'm going to go enjoy this and ponder whether or not I should post this damn thing. Catch you later.